This is John Colin with growingyourgreens.com. A very special treat for you today. I was at the farmer's market, my local farmer's market here, and I met Tyler Tebridge from Future Farms. And, you know, we got to talking about growing food and stuff, and he's like, hey, man, why don't you come check out my farms? I was like, yeah, it'd be great for my viewers to see what, you know, a real farmer's doing. And, you know, amazingly enough, he's using the square foot gardening method. So I got really excited, and he has chickens and, I don't know, quails and chickens, and like, this is like the urban backyard. I mean, we're just literally like really a couple blocks from my house here. This is an acre. He's actually farming about a quarter acre, and it's amazing. He's gonna go over a lot of the different techniques he uses to share with you guys, and you know, I'm gonna learn some stuff too for sure. So let's talk with Tyler. So Tyler, why did you want to start a farm and do all this stuff?
Well, farming is a really therapeutic activity, and originally I started it as a way to take my mind off of work and kind of just have a healthy activity out in the sun. And it grew into something where I said, hey, I wouldn't mind making a couple extra dollars off of this. And I got compulsive and just built this really large garden. So, and you know, with the surplus of vegetables that I had, I wanted to move them, so we started working the farmers markets, and you know, one thing led to the next, and now we're trying to get some restaurants and, you know, just growing as much vegetables as we can. But it's a very therapeutic, healthy hobby, and that's one of the main reasons why I started.
So do you do this full time, or is this like just a part-time passion? You have a real job and you kind of do this on the side? Or
yeah, I have a full-time job on the side, and then a full-time job on the side. So I have two full-time jobs, I like to say. And yeah, it's a lot of work, but you know, you don't have to do it on a large scale. You can grow a lot of vegetables in a small amount of space, and it doesn't take a lot of work. But yeah, this is, you know, so at some point I'd like this to be my full-time job. That's where I'm going.
So if you have two full-time jobs, that means you work 80 hours a week and then you still take care of all this?
Yeah. Well, I mean, this is my other full-time job.
I see, all right.
So I'd say that, yeah, it's about, I mean, it's anywhere from 20 to 40 hours a week out here. It depends on the season.
I see.
And what I'm doing, yeah. So
yeah, that's good for people to know. I mean, he's managing a quarter acre on basically 20 hours a week. So if you just have a small box, I mean, that's a couple hours a week easily.
Yeah.
No problem. So, I mean, even if you're not going to do this scale, I mean, I don't even have this much stuff growing yet.
No, this is a farm right here. It's a farm. It's a landscaped farm, I like to call it. If you're going to get into farming and you actually do want to sell your vegetables, you have to grow the veggies, first of all. That takes time, but then you also have to factor in harvesting, cleaning the vegetables, taking them to the market, and then the actual time at the market itself. So all that's included in the farming schedule.
I see.
So it's not just out here watering, it's also the 3 hours that you spend at the market, the 2 hours that you spend loading and unloading, and then the 2 hours that you spend harvesting and cleaning your vegetables before you take them to the market. All that adds up. So if you just want to grow for your dinner table or your lunch table, for your family, friends, it's really easy and it doesn't take a lot of work.
Hey, let's go down to your farm now and check it out and learn more about what Tyler's doing here. So come on. All right, so today we're going to talk with Tyler about growing things vertically. He has many raised beds, growing many things vertically. I see watermelons, pumpkins, tomatoes, cucumbers. So let's take a look at just some of the things he's growing vertically. And you know, the pumpkins, man, there's a lot of weight on some of those trellises. So let's go over there first and check it out. So we're here with Tyler, and this is his, he's growing in the square foot gardening method, as I had mentioned. And he's using the nylon string trellis. And so, you know, you may have saw that I built an 8-foot by 8-foot monster trellis for my pumpkins, but you know, he was a lot smarter and he's just using a nylon string trellis, which is supporting all these pumpkins up on here. So now we're gonna have Tyler talk to us about pumpkins and growing pumpkins and how he's using it to support it, and if this nylon string actually holds it, and how he does it all.
Well, first off, these aren't my ideas. I have to, you know, give credit where it's due. It's Mel Bartholomew, the guy who wrote the Square Foot Garden book, and I just took his ideas and have sort of run with them. The trellis netting can hold up to 70 pounds, if not more. I've never taken it that far, but I'm guessing that there's, each one of these pumpkins weighs at least 7 pounds, and there's about, I don't know, 7 on there. So it's getting up there in weight. How many did you count there?
About 11 or 12.
11 or 12. So yeah, I mean, it's getting up there. As you can see, my electrical conduit's starting to sag a little bit, but it's not going to break. This stuff's actually really sturdy. So what I need to do next, as soon as I harvest these, is just put a middle support in. The reason why people like to hang trellis pumpkins is it looks really cool. That's why I do it. It keeps the pumpkins off the ground, and a lot of times if you just let your pumpkins sit on the ground, they'll develop mold or they'll be kind of soggy on one side. This totally exposes them to air. It's way healthier for your fruit. Last year I grew a pumpkin that was about 25 pounds on one of these trellises. What you want to do if you grow a really large fruit is you support it with pantyhose works, any sort of kind of stretchy nylon, and you just basically create a hammock for the fruit itself and let it finish its growth period in there. So yeah, growing pumpkins up trellises is cool. It makes a really nice wall as well. You can make shade areas with squash and pumpkins, watermelon, any vining crop, cucumbers. And these are sugar pie pumpkins. They're really good to cook with. Really good pumpkin pie. I'm gonna, in a couple weeks, be making a lot of pumpkin pie. Looking forward to it.
All right, cool. So how many pumpkin plants do you actually have here?
So in Mel's book, The Square Foot Garden, he recommends planting the pumpkins every 2 square feet. So for 2 square feet, you have 1 pumpkin. This year, I just did 1 for 1 square foot. So it's kind of up to you. I do have my suspicions that had I just let them, if I would have planted them 1 every 2 feet, I would have gotten the exact same production out of 1 plant as I'm getting out of 2. So if that makes sense, it's kind of, a very important thing about planting is spacing. And a plant will produce under close proximity. But if you give a plant the proper room, it will actually grow to its full potential. And we'll talk about that more as we go, but I'd say for these pumpkins, if you're gonna trellis pumpkins, it's anywhere from 1 square foot to 2 square feet. And mess around, do your own experiments at home. I kind of planted these really close together because I wanted a wall of green, and I got that. In the middle here, we've got some melons. These were kind of a failed experiment. They didn't do so well. The squash grows, a squash is pumpkin. It grows a lot faster than melons, and if you plant squash and melons too close together, a lot of times the squash or pumpkins will overrun it. And one thing about melons is that they need a lot of sunlight and a lot of heat, so I kind of shaded them out a little bit.
So you can see here, Tyler is growing things vertically. I mean, even though he has a half acre to grow on, growing vertical is really important to him. I see almost every raised bed has a trellis on it, and he's making the trellis out of the basically electrical conduit and the nylon string trellis. And this is one of the most affordable ways and actually long lasting ways to grow on a trellis, and it looks like it's really easy to install. So let's ask Tyler about why he's using this kind of trellis and how he installed it and how it's been working.
So the way that you install it what you do is you got to get your electrical conduit. So these beds are all measured out because of the square foot method. They're each 4 by 4 feet. So what you do is you get a 4 foot piece of, or you get a 10 foot piece of electrical conduit. If you want a 5 foot trellis, you cut that in half. Then you get a 5 foot piece of conduit, cut that down to 4 feet. This would be the crossbar here. And then this trellis is actually 6 feet tall. So, but anyways, You just cut your, I use a hacksaw and just, saw them. And then you use your corner brackets here to put the conduit in place. The way that it's, this will never blow over. I mean, I guess that a hurricane would actually maybe take these out. But they're really, really sturdy. And what the secret of that is you put rebar in the ground here. And
how far up does rebar come?
I get 4 foot pieces of, if I'm making a trellis that's over 6 feet tall, I use a 4 foot piece of rebar. I go 2 feet deep and then 2 feet up. So that is really secure. That 10 foot trellis over there, if you can see that through the camera, has just 2 feet of rebar above the ground. But it's got 2 feet of rebar in the ground as well. And it's really, really sturdy. That's really essentially what is going to keep your trellis from falling over. And that's why this will last a lifetime just in this, in the ground where it is right now. And the nice thing is that they're portable too. You can just, I can't really do it right now because there's plants kind of vining on here. But if I want to, if I want to redesign my garden a little bit, all I have to do is lift the trellis up, move it to another spot in the garden, and I've got a whole different feel, a look, you know, depending on how high I want to grow. One of my recommendations is don't do a 5 foot trellis. Do 6 feet, 7 feet. Go big. It's more fun. They grow bigger. You'll be surprised at how tall a pumpkin can get, and even how tall tomatoes get. I mean, they get over 10 feet easy under the right growing conditions. To just kind of re-explain this, this is half-inch electrical conduit right here. Half-inch electrical conduit with corner brackets, and then half-inch metal rebar, 48 inches. And the rebar is really important, and it gets a little expensive. I'm not gonna lie about it. If you have a friend that can weld for you, that will save you a lot of money because these brackets run from $250 to $350, and the rebar is expensive as well. Rebar gets really expensive, but the actual conduit is super cheap. I think that a 10-foot pull of half-inch electrical conduit runs you like $2 or something. So yeah, if you're making a couple, I mean, obviously I have a lot, so I've invested a good amount of money in these trellises, but they're totally portable. If I ever need to move my farm, or if I ever want to kind of move some of these over to my other planting site in Santa Rosa, I can do it really easily.
I hope you've enjoyed our visit here to Future Farm with Tyler, and he's invited me back to come back for future episodes. So he's open to having people visit his farm and share his knowledge, his wealth of knowledge, through email. You could contact him at helping_u_and_grow. So helpingyougrow@gmail.com. So once again, this is John Kohler from growingyourgreens.com, and keep on growing.